Hello students, welcome to the Gate Academy. So I hope that all of your papers went quite well. And to help you analyze that how your paper went, we are here for you with the video solutions. So in this video, we will be solving the engineering mathematics questions which are asked from EC paper in today's paper. Also, I am very proud to announce that we are the first institute in India that is providing the video solutions of all the paper. And to get the full analysis of your paper and the answer key, please go in the description below and get the link. Okay, so before any wasting any time, we should start the video. So let me see the first question. So first question which was asked is, two sides of a fair coin are labeled as 0 and 1. So there is a coin with not head and tail, but 0 and 1 as the sides mentioned. Okay, now the coin is tossed two times independently. This is the condition given, and let M and N denote the labels corresponding to the outcomes of these two tosses. For a random variable X, which is minimum of M or N, you have to find the expectation. Okay, so very good question from probability. Okay, 1 mark question from in this paper. So let's see what is mentioned. So first of all, this is the chapter of probability. So let's see what is given. We have been given that there is a random variable X, which is the minimum of M or N. And what is M or N? M or N is the labels. It denotes the labels, that is 0 and 1. So now let's see what are the respective outcomes. And for those outcomes, what is the random variable X? Okay, as we do in a normal question from random variable, that we will do. So outcomes, because the coin is tossed two times, so outcomes can be like this one. Like you are getting on both the tosses, you are getting 0 and 0, or on both the tosses, you are getting 0, 1. Similarly, 1, 0 and 1, 1. It is the same thing like you toss two coins and you are getting head, 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 tail, tail, head and tail, tail. But the now in this in instead of head and tail, you will have 0 and 1 as your outcomes. Now for this, what is the random variable for this particular outcome? 0, 0. Now minimum of M or N, we have M and N both as 0. So X will be definitely 0 here because both are same. For the second case, 0 and 1, M and N are 0 and 1. Minimum of these two is obviously again 0. So for this also, for this particular outcome also, you will have X as 0. Coming to the third outcome, again you will have X, is this X as 0, again the minimum is 0. And for this one, can you tell me what will be the X value? Definitely it will be your 1. Okay, so now this is the particular case. Now if I ask you what is the probability of X equal to 0, now you can easily see that 0 is occurring 3 times out of 4 times, so probability is the 3 by 4. Okay, very easy. Tell me probability of X equal to 1. Tell me in the comments who have solved this question correctly. P of X equal to 1, because one time you are getting X equal to 1, so 1 by 4. Expectation is defined as the summation of X values with the corresponding probability. So for X equal to 0, you have probability 3 by 4. For X equal to 1, you have probability 1 by 4. So final answer 1 by 4, which is 0.25. This was the answer to this question. Very easy question, just they have changed head and tail into 0 and 1. Okay, so tell me in the comments who all have solved this question correctly and who all are getting the positive marks for this one. Okay, so moving ahead. So moving ahead, the next question that we have seen in the paper is from vector calculus. So again, the question was very easy. It was a 1 mark question. And the question is as follows. For a vector field A, which of the following is false? For a vector field A, which of the following is false? You have to tell. And the options were given that del cross A is a vector field. This was the first option. Second option was A is irrotational. A is irrotational if del square A is 0. Third option was this value. All of you know that this is what? Curl of A. So this is equal to gradient of divergence of A minus Laplacian of A. And last option was A is solenoidal. What do you mean by solenoidal? A field which is free from divergence is solenoidal. So A is solenoidal if del dot A is 0. So what do you think? Which one statement is false? Reply in the comments. So obviously this is a vector field. We know that curl of a vector field is a again vector field. So yes, this is correct. A is irrotational. When the field is irrotational, when its curl is 0. So irrotational means curl should be 0. But they are talking about this thing, which is Laplacian. So obviously this statement is false, means this statement is the answer. If you go for answer, option C also, this is also correct. You can see that the scalar triple product will give you this value for curl of F. So this is correct. So this is not your answer definitely. And I have already told solenoidal means divergence free field and divergence will be 0. So this is correct, means not your answer. So yes, all of you are answering very right. Answer is option B, means it is irrotational because it will be irrotation only when the curl is 0, not this quantity as 0. Okay, so very good, everybody has answered. Tell me how many got this as correct in their paper. Okay, so let's solve third question. So we are solving engineering mathematics question from today's paper. Please share the link to all of our friends also who must be thinking that how their paper went well or not. So engineering mathematics, you know that it grabs quite a lot of amount of weightage in your paper. So please share the link if it helps to you also. So the next question is from linear algebra and some equations were given. Actually, 4 equations were given. So I am writing those equations on the board. So you must have attempted this question. Tell me what answer did you get? So this system, it was given that for this system, the solution of the system is, you had to find the solution, and options were given as B3 equal to 2B1 with so it was a 2-mark question in your paper, and this time they have not given 3 equations with 3 variable but 4 equations for 2 variable. So this is the change this time in the paper. Tell me what answer did you get? Okay, so again this type of question can be solved by using the concept of augmented matrix method. Augmented matrix means I'll draw what is the augmented matrix here, and then I'll try to find the rank of augmented matrix and the coefficient matrix. So this is your augmented matrix. Okay, here it will be a 9. So if I see, if I want to convert this into row echelon form for finding out the rank, then what you will do, you will on R2 you will apply this operation, and R3 you will apply R3 minus 3R1, and on R4 you will apply R4 minus 3 R1. So these are the operations that you will apply so that your augmented matrix will change into 1, 2, B1 and the row 2. 2 times R1 means 0 here, 0 here, and here you will get B2 as this one. Then 3 times R1, 0 here, 4 minus 3, 4 minus, sorry, it was a 7 here. Change this, 7 here. Okay. So we have grabbed these questions from a lot of effort. So please do watch it for video solutions. So 7 here. So 7 minus 6 will give you 1. And here you will get B3 minus 3 B1. And lastly, you will have 0, 9 minus 6, that is 3. And B4 minus 3 B1. Okay. Now what you can do, because you are getting two zeros here, so I will reshuffle these rows. Like I will interchange R4 with R4 with R2, and then again these two rows among themselves means I am doing the shuffling and writing the matrix. So 1, 2, B1, 0. I'm writing the third row as the second row. So 0, 1, B3 minus 3, B1. Then I'm writing this R4 as R3. So 0, 3, B4 minus 3, B1. And lastly, 0, 0, R2, B2 minus 3, B1. Sorry, 2, B1. Okay. So this is the augmented matrix. Now, finally applying the operation on R3. What is the operation that you will apply? R3 minus 3, R2. So from here, you will get this as 1, 0, 0, 2, 1. B1, B3 minus 3, B1 and minus 3 times this, so minus 3 times B3 plus 6 times B1. Okay, so 3 times 3 is 9, so 9 times B1, and lastly here you will be having B2 minus 2 B1. Okay, so out of all these efforts, you must have gotten to this form. So now your task is done. Now, condition is you have to find the solution. So solution will exist only when the condition is rank of AB is equal to rank of A. For the existence of solution or for the system to be consistent, we know that both of the ranks should be equal. Yes. Okay. So now you can see that rank of A is definitely 2. You can see A is this matrix. A is this matrix, both of the rows for this A is becoming 0. So rank of A is 2. That means rank of AB must also be 2. That means that B2 should be equal to 2B1 and B2 should be equal to 2B1. That is, this is 0. And this should also be 0. That means B4 minus 3B1 minus 3B3 plus 9B1. Equal to 0. If you just simplify this, you will get this as 6b1 minus 3b3 plus b4 equal to 0. Now let's check the option. So b2 equal to 2b1, and you can definitely see your answer is option C. Your answer was option C. Yes, Abhi is telling some method. Yes, that is also a quite useful method, that you can see that for A matrix 1, 2, 2, 4, that means that for the matrix A, there will be one dependency. That means B2 should also be equal to twice B1. But what about the other relation? To get that other relation, you should go for this form only. Okay, by checking the dependency, you can only arrive at this first relation, that is B2 equal to 2B1. But what about the other one? That other one you can only get if you solve through this method. Okay, so I think you got the concept. Okay. Now, let's go ahead with the next question. Okay, interchange. Okay, it's okay, but for my case, it is option C. Okay, let's go to the other question now. So, other question that was asked from the chapter of calculus, and it was from the topic of partial derivatives. So, let's look at that question. So the question I am writing for you, it was फाइंड आउट द पार्शियल डेरिवेटिव विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एक्स ऑफ दिस क्वांटिटी एंड दिस पार्शियल डिफरेंसिएशन वॉज टू बी कैलकुलेटेड एट द पॉइंट 10e. So, did you get the answer to this question? How many of you got the answer? Tell me in the comments what is the answer and how many of you got it correctly. So, yes, zero. Whoever is answering zero, you are very correct. Very good, Rekha. You have got it correct only. So, let's differentiate this with respect to x. So, one thing to note here is that whenever you are not mentioned anything about the variables, then you will consider them as the dependent variable only. Okay. So, if y is independent variable only. Okay. What I'm saying is, x, y and z, there is no condition is mentioned among those. So what we will say that x, y and z are independent variables. So treating y and z independent of x, we will differentiate this thing. So you will get this as exponentials differentiation is exponential again. So this will be the differentiation of this function. Then again differentiation of this power. So it will give you one differentiation zero. Cos y is a constant and x differentiation with respect to x is 1. So this is the differentiation. Now the second term's differentiation, okay, treating this as constant because x, z and y are independent of each other. So this will become differentiation of x as 1. Okay, now we are required this value at x equal to 1, y equal to 0 and z equal to e. So let's substitute what is happening. Okay, so this will be e 1 minus x, x is 1, cos y 0, so 1 by minus cos 0 and here you will get cos of 0 plus z value is e and then we have minus 1 plus 0. So finally what you are getting is e to the power 1 minus cos 0, you know cos 0 value is 1, so it is coming out to be e to the power 0 which is 1 and here you will have minus cos 0 means minus 1 plus e to the power minus 1 e to the power plus 1 multiplied are getting you 1. So final answer is 0. That means your option B is your right answer. How many of you got it correctly? Please reply. This question was asked for 1 mark. This question was asked for 1 mark, Abhishek. Okay. Yes, everybody answered. Okay. So let's move to the next question, which was a very interesting question from vector space. Topic is vector space. Chapter is linear algebra. So let's see that question. So let's see that question. So there was given that there are 6 vectors v1, v2, v3 up to v6. So 6 vectors were given like this. Some vector were given, 6 vectors, and these vectors lie in a R4 space. Okay, so first of all, from this statement, what you should get that because this is a R4 space, that means there should be 4 linearly independent vectors for this vector space. Okay, if it were been like R3 space or we can say our Cartesian coordinate, then we have 3 independent linearly independent vectors. Similarly, for this dimensional, for fourth dimensional space, you will have fourth four number of linearly independent vectors. Now let's see what was the question. So for this space, which one of the following is false? This was asked, which one of the following is false? So first statement was, any four vectors form basis for R4. This was the first statement. Second statement was, if V1, V2, V3 and V6 span R4, so this was the second statement. You have to choose the option which is incorrect. Third one was, these vectors are not linearly independent. Not linearly independent. And fourth option, it is not necessary that vectors okay, so this 4 is here. Now, if I look at the options, then there are some terms given in the option. First term is this basis. What is basis? Basis is nothing but, basis is defined for a vector space and it is nothing but the set of linearly independent vectors. Basis is what? Basis means, basis is a term associated with vector space. It is the set of linearly independent vector in your vector space. This is the term basis. And second term which the options talked about was this term which is span. So what is span? Can anybody tell me? Span. Span is nothing but the linear combination of all the vectors which forms the basis. Means it is just a combination of all the linearly independent vectors. So linear combination of linearly independent vectors. This is the span. Okay, if you know these two terms, you can easily solve this question. Now let's go dive into the question. So first option, any four vectors form basis for R4. Will this be correct? So no, this will not be the correct answer. Why? Because any four vectors can't be your basis. Basis is the specified. Basis is specified as the set of linearly independent vectors. You know that this is a six. These are six vectors which form this, which are present in this space. And in this space, we have already seen that there will be four linearly independent vectors. So only those vectors which are linearly independent will form the basis, not any of these six vectors. Okay, so basically this will be your answer. Answer is option A. Again, I'm repeating. Why? Because any four vector does not form the basis. It is the set of linearly independent vectors which will form the basis. Okay. Yes, I'm telling you, Sachin. Yes, you are right. Only I'm telling you the same thing, that the question was, which of the following statement is false? So this one is false. Okay. Because any of the four vectors can't form the basis. It is the linearly independent vectors which form the basis. Now, if we look at the option B also, they are saying that these four vectors span R4, then it forms a basis. Yes, correct. I have told you span is what? Linear combination of linearly independent vectors. So if these vectors span this R4, that means they will form the basis. This is correct only because this means that span means that they are linearly independent. They should lie in the basis. So this is not false. This is true. That's why this is not the answer. Next, these vectors are not linearly independent. Again, because they are in the space of R4, only four vectors will be linearly independent, except those two vectors will be definitely dependent. So these are not linearly independent is true because all are not linearly independent. Only four will be linearly independent. Okay. So again, C option is true. And lastly, it is not necessary that vectors span R4. not necessary that vectors span R4. That is also true because we have told you R4 space means 4 linearly independent vectors. That doesn't mean that all 6 will span this R4. So yes, option A is right. This was a tricky question if you have not read the topic of vector space, which most of the students leave, but this time they have asked the question. So what about option C? Harish is asking. Okay, Brijesh is also asking, so I'll repeat again. C is saying these vectors are not linearly independent. These vectors are not linearly independent. I have told you because there are 4 linearly independent vectors, so among these 6 vectors, 2 will be definitely dependent. So that's why they are not linearly independent. So again, all of the 6 vectors are not linearly independent. There are some dependent vectors. Okay. Understood or not? Should I move ahead? Why? What is the explanation for C? All of these vectors, that is V1, V2, V3 and so on, V6 are not linearly independent. Any 4 only will be linearly independent. Obviously 2 will be linearly dependent. Okay, so I think you have understood the concept. So let's move ahead with the next question. So I think you are all discussing about the differential equation question. So I'll move to that question first then. On the public demand, let's move to that question. So differential equation, which one of the following option contains 2 solution of the differential equation given? So let me write that question first. Okay, so the differential equation given was this one, which you already have written in the comments. So this was the differential equation given. Okay, and the question was, which one of the following options contain 2 solutions? You have to find out 2 solutions for this one among the options. So options were ln mod y minus 1. This was the first option, second option. Okay, so let's move to this question. Now, because there is a solution, so let's solve this differential equation first of all. You can easily see that this is a very easy differential equation, which can be solved by using the variable separable method. Very easy differential equation, variable separable method. Okay, let's solve this by separating the variables, which is like this, y minus 1, x dx. So solution, already you can see that this is 1 by y minus 1. So solution will be ln mod of y minus 1 equal to x square by 2 plus c, or writing in the form of options, you can write it as ln y minus 1 0.5 x square plus c. So from this you have arrived at the solution that this options which may be correct are option A or option C. These 2 options are already eliminated. Okay, you must have gotten to this point. Now the thing is, will y equal to minus 1 be a solution or y equal to 1 be a solution? So for that, just go with the basics. Don't get confused, just go with the basics. So let's say y equal to 1 is a solution. Okay, I'm checking whether it is a solution or not. So if y equal to 1 is a solution, then the differential equation which has been given will be 0. Y equal to 1, if you substitute here, this will be 1 minus 1, dy by dx will be 0. And it should also be correct because y equal to 1 is a constant function. This is a constant function. You know that for a constant function, the differentiation or the dy by dx should be 0, and that we are getting from here. So yes, it can be the solution, and it is the solution. Let's check for y equal to minus for the sake. So let's say y equal to minus 1 is the solution. So as soon as you substitute y equal to minus 1, what are you getting? Y equal to minus 1, if you substitute, you are getting dy by dx as minus 2x. If you differentiate this equation, you will not get this as minus 2x. You will again get dy by dx as 0 only, because differentiation of a constant function is 0. So definitely which option is correct? So option C is your right answer. Y equal to 1 is the solution. Y equal to minus 1 is not the solution. Okay. Thank you, Shivraj. If anybody is having any doubt, please ask. So ln 0 not exist. So that is also a thing, but from that you can't conclude that whether it will be a solution or not. Okay, because ln equal to 0 means x can be infinite. That can happen also. We can't conclude that it is from there that there is a solution or not. Please repeat option C. This one, I am saying, let's say y equal to 1 is the solution. That means the differential equation for this function should be the same as given by this equation. So if I differentiate this y equal to 1, this being a constant function, its differentiation should be 0. And again, if you substitute y equal to 1 here, you are getting that as 0. That means y equal to 1 is the solution. But this is not true for y equal to minus 1. Okay. So this is how you have to solve this question, like this. Okay. So I think we have discussed it very nicely. So let's move ahead to the next question. Next question that I will discuss is again very easy question from the chapter of differential equations, okay, where you have to find the solution of a second order differential equation. So that was a very easy question from the differential equation. So I think most of you must have solved that question. So the question was d2y by dx square, d2y by dx square minus 6dy by dx plus 9y is equal to 0. You have to find out the solution, and the options were given as So these were the options. Tell me what is the answer. Yes, A is correct. Very good. A is the answer. No big deal. It was a very good question. Very easy question. So if I write the auxiliary equation for this differential equation, that it will be m square minus 6m plus 9 equal to 0. And this is a very easy equation to solve. You will get m as 3 and 3. So you know that the solutions are real. The solutions are real and they are repeating. For that case, we have the equation of complementary function as, or because here we have 0 only, so there will be no PI. So this complementary function will directly be equal to the general solution, which is y, and that we will write it as c1 plus xc2 times e to the power 3x. This will be the solution which was given in the option A. So option A is right. Yes, one mark question, very easy. Okay, so let's go to the next question. So next question that I am taking is from the chapter of triple, sorry, chapter of calculus, and the topic was triple integral. I think most of you must have found this question difficult. So tell me how many of you found it difficult to solve. Okay, so let's look at the question. So you have to find out the value of this over S, where this is given by, and this region was given as, okay, so this was the given question x, y and z, and these values were given as 1 and 1 and 3. Actually, by looking at the question, you will find this question as very typical, but it was not so. So what did you get the answer as? 4.5. How did you get 4.5? 4.5 is not the answer. Everybody made the mistake. How come so? The similar mistake. Okay, let's see what is happening here. So if I ask you to look at this region S, can you give me this straight line equation? What will be the equation of this straight line? So you can see that it is in the yz plane and it is intersecting at y equal to 1 and z equal to 1. So that means the equation will be y plus z equal to 1. Yes, y plus z equal to 1. So this is the equation of this line. Now this question is quite easy. Why? Because you can assume it to be like, if you forget about this volume or this S region, and if you only talk about this triangle, let me name this as ABC. So if you only look at this triangle ABC, then what will happen? This double integral, if I write this equation as this, okay, why I'm writing like this? Because x is independent of y and z here. You can see that there is a relationship between y and z, but x is not involved in here, and the limit for x will be constant. It is like this only, that this triangle has been like stretched over to from x equal to 0 to x equal to 3. That is the thing happening here. So what is happening? You know that this, you can calculate the area of this triangle, and then you need to project this area by this times of this single integration. Understood or not? What is happening here? X is constant irrespective of y and z. So now we can just distribute this integration into like this, x dx plus dy dz, where x is varying from this point to this point, means x equal to 0 to x equal to 3. Very simple question, x equal to 0 to x equal to 3. And y, if I talk about y, and if I just find the double integration for this part, then y is varying from y equal to 0 to y equal to 1 minus z, and z is varying from 0 to 1. So this is the limits for y equal to 0 to y equal to 1. This is the limit for z, and these are the limits for x equal to 0 to x equal to 3. Now the thing is, you also need not to calculate this double integral. As you know, this dy dz means just similar as the area of that triangle. So now we will solve this. This integration will be x square by 2, limits 0 to 3, and this double integration is area of triangle ABC. So if you substitute the limits, it will be 9 by 2 into area of triangle ABC. What will be the area of triangle ABC? Half into base, that is 1, into height, that is again 1. So answer is 9 by 4, which is 2.25. This is the final answer to this question. In looking, this question was very difficult, but it is actually easy question, because you can see that x is independent with respect to y and z. So you can just split this integration into one single integration and one double integration. Okay, I think you got the point and you understood the question. So let's move ahead to the next question, which will be the last question of this session. I think you enjoyed the session. I think you all have seen the solution. So please, if you found this session as helpful, please share the video to all of your friends so that they can watch it later also. So let's move to the last question. Again, this last question was very typical one. So don't go anywhere. Just wait for 5 minutes more. Okay, so for a random variable x following uniform distribution, so there is a random variable x which follows uniform distribution, and it is given that x is belonging from minus 2 to 10. Okay, and there is another random variable y which is following this relationship, 2x minus 6. The required probability, the question is, find this probability. This is a conditional probability question. Very good, very typical question to solve. Okay, so let's see how this goes. Okay, so let's look at, so first of all, the thing is that this is following uniform distribution, so we can easily find what will be its PDF, probability density function. Can you tell me what will be the PDF? Yes, it will be 10 minus minus 2, that is 1 by 12. Okay, so if I draw the distribution for this, it is varying from minus 2, let's say this is minus 2 and this is 10, so minus 2 to 10, and the distribution function is 12, 1 by 12, sorry. So this value is 1 by 12, this is P of x and this is x, okay. So this we have got, that this function is varying like this. Now the thing is, what will be the uniform, what will be the distribution for y? So again, if x is varying uniformly, why because it is a function of x, it will also vary uniformly. So y will also vary uniformly. Let's find out how will y vary. So if x is minus 2, then you can find out that this will be, so x is minus 2, I have substituted here, so minus 2, minus 2, minus 4, and it is minus 10. And when x is 10, then you will get y as 2 times 10 minus 6, 20 minus 6, that is 14. So f of y will be 1 by 24. Again, using the same formula, and because it will be varying like uniformly only, so it will be 1 by 14 minus minus 10, that is 1 by 24. Now if I see this probability, y is less than equal to 7. When y is less than equal to 7, okay, I'm writing down y is less than equal to 7. Y, we know that it is nothing but 2x minus 6 is less than equal to 7. This means nothing but x is, 2 times x is less than equal to 13, that is x is less than equal to 13 by 2. X is less than equal to 13 by 2. So again, I can write this same quantity as, it is the same as x is less than 13 by 2. Conditional x is greater than 5. Okay, I think you understood it, the question step by step. So what we have done, we have just found how is y varying. So y is varying from minus 10 to 14. I have calculated f of y, and when y is less than equal to 7, that means x will be less than equal to 13 by 2. So this equation becomes like this. Okay, so now let's look at where will be minus 13 by 2. So it is minus 5 will be somewhat here. Let's say this is 5 and this is minus 13 by 2 means 6.5. Okay, so let's say this is the x equal to 5 and x equal to 6.5. You know that conditional probability this can be written as probability of intersection of these two probabilities. Probabilities of intersection means x less than 13 by 2 but greater than 5 by 2. So can I write that this is nothing but this, and in denominator you will have this as greater than equal to 5. Okay, I have just used the formula for conditional probability. The numerator will be intersection of these two probabilities and denominator will be the probability of the condition imposed. Okay, now what this means, probability of x lying between 5 to 3, 13 by 2, that is 6.5, it means nothing but this area of this rectangle, let's name this as A, B, C, D. So I can say that it is the area of rectangle A, B, C, D. And what is the probability of x greater than equal to 5? It is the same as the area of this rectangle. Let's name this as A and F. So it will be area of A, D, E and F. A, D, E and F. Now it is very easy to calculate the areas. So area of ABCD. ABCD is a rectangle with width as 1.5, height as 1 by 12. So I am writing down here. So the required probability is 1.5 into 1 by 12. That is the area of this rectangle ABCD. And lastly, area of ADEF. ADEF, this length is 5. So 5 into again height is 12. So answer is 1.5 by 5. That is 0.3. 0.3 is the answer to this question. How many of you got it correctly? Yes, very good. Who have answered? I think you understood the question, how to solve this. It is very easy question. The thing only complicated was to convert this into this part. If you can convert y into x, then you can replace the probabilities in terms of x and by using the area. Why area? Because probability is nothing but the area under the curve in definite integration for a continuous random variable. That's why using the area concept, we have calculated this probability. Okay, I think you found this session as very useful for you. If you have any doubts, you can comment in the section below. And please subscribe to our channel and please share this video to all of your friends. Thank you. Have a nice day and take rest now. Thank you.